Hi, this is Robert Smith. I'm in Craig and Old South Wales. One of the questions people ask me, well, show me how to tap. How do you tap on myself? All right. I've been tapping for a long time, about 18 years. Yeah, 18 years, since 99. And some of the best ways I use to tap on myself, I'm very conscious of my body's reaction. I'm very aware of what bothers me, what upsets me, what frustrates me at certain times, or what people bother me. There's several ways for me to do it. I just notice my body, I notice the reaction in my body, and I tap. I also, I just tap and say, let it go, let it go, let it go, let it go. Peace. And then I just think of something positive, then I go right back again, I think about what they did. So I think about what bothers me, does it still bother me a little bit? I just do it again, let it go, let it go, let it go. Peace. And then I just think about something else. Then I go back and check it again, and I see what still bothers me. Now, right now, it's like it's a neutral thing. It's like not positive, not negative. So I was oftentimes, after I do that, I just say, whatever was there, whatever it represents, I'm safe to just let it go. And then I think about what it was, and then I will change in my mind. I'll turn it where they're smiling, we give a hug, or they're saying something positive. And then I just feel good. Then I will go to another memory and feel that feeling, and then I add it to it. So that's one way. Another way is when it's really, really strong. Understanding that we're hypnosis machines, that means when somebody triggers us and makes us feel really bad, when we're feeling really bad, we're in a deep trance. I remember one time I was in Riga, Latvia, and that's back when my friends or my fans who were attacking me, people who I really liked, and that's back when I had people who were personally attacking me and personally attacking my friends, and I was in Riga, Latvia, and something happened, and then in my head I created a bad scenario that wasn't true, but it felt so true. And so I'm tapping, and it wasn't going away. I've been teaching this for a long time. I know how it works. I was so deep into my own fear and my own trance, I couldn't get out of it. Luckily, I had a friend of mine that was there who's a practitioner. Her name is Maya. She was there and she started tapping on me, and then she started doing one of the defracts. The defracts was cluck like a chicken. She'd go brock, 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 and it pulled me out of the trance. It yanked me out of it. Then we went back and started tapping on it and then cleaned it up. So depending on the emotional intensity is what you do differently. So for me, even though I've been doing it, and by the way, I would have cleaned it up eventually, but it was really, really big. So one of the other ways that I realize when I tap, if it's really big, I will tap, but I'll lift my head up and I roll my eyes back and forth. Now, I don't do this in public too much because it looks a little bit strange, but it really works, because when you lift your head up, you move your eyes back and forth. It's a defract. Also, move your thoughts away from whatever it is that's traumatizing you, affecting you, and bothering you. Then you go back and check it again, see what's left, do it again. These are really very important ways, because tapping is a great skill, but the trance in your mind could be a lot stronger than the tapping. You know, back when I first started learning how to tap, I learned from Gary Craig and his VHS tapes. I bought his Ultimate Therapist course, and I went to several seminars, and we were taught to associate and to feel it and to stay focused on it and then try to tap your way out of it. That is a big mistake, because if the mind has the trance or the problem is really big, it can be a lot stronger than any tapping will ever occur. So this is a fine tuning on how to work on yourself. Because oftentimes when people are going into their stuff, this is the peak of the emotions, and if you're so much in it, it's hard to get out of it. So these are some of the little tidbits that I use on myself. A lot of times I just do it in my head. So I look at you and I'll do the tapping. And in my mind, I just think about it, in a deep breath, and peace. So I do it mentally as well. Also, other ways I do it, since with this tapping process, we create what you call a power point. And that's when you grab your wrist, you're creating what you call a positive anchor, which means relaxation and peace. Oftentimes when I'm triggered, and I'm feeling it in my mind, I'll go peace, peace, peace. Deep breath. And I'll go back and do it again. Peace, peace, peace. And it works really well for me too. But see, I've been practicing for a long time, and a lot of times you build it up. I teach my clients on how to mentally tap. So that means you can do it when nobody knows, you know, and if you're in a business meeting or your partner and she's irritating you or he's irritating you, and you can just do it in your mind. And she'll say, you know, I feel like you really listen to me. I feel like we connect. And all you do is just tapping on yourself, creating harmony within yourself. That's where your power is. So these are some of the ways that I do it on myself. There's other ways that I do it as well, depending on what scenario it is, where I at locally, if I'm doing the different parts, because there are about 6 different areas that we do the tapping, and I will talk about that in another video. So just keep tapping on yourself. Learn to be your own master of your own mind, and learn how to take control of your own thoughts and create the life you always wanted. And by doing that, you change what you hold in your head, you change your responses, and then you'll overcome things that others couldn't do. It's Robert Smith here in Wells. Peace.